Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So on today's episode of makeup tutorial, I'll be recreating a look I saw online on my beautiful model Eniola. Eniola, say hi.
Hi.
Show you guys the look on the screen right now, and we are going to be recreating it. I hope we do well, and please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have been learning one or two things from my channel, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to share my content so that others can also benefit from it. So guys, without further ado, let's get right into the video. Micellar water and this baby wipes to clean our face. Many of you guys have asked me to do my prep video, and I'll basically be doing my prep video in this makeup tutorial, and also show you guys other things that I do to bring out that amazing look that you see. So guys, I do not want this video to be the same way like the whole process video, so I'm going to be sharing with you. I don't know who needs to hear this, but I want you to know that if I had given up on my dreams concerning this makeup, the pressure from family and many other things, hindrances that were just there at the beginning, I would not be here filming this video or you being able to learn from me. I know that a lot of you have been dropping comments asking me what I use, and if I'm not doing anything right, I'm sure that you guys will not be dropping those questions. It's because you see value in what I do, and I am grateful for it. Thank you guys for always showing me love on every post that I bring up here. So my point here is that no matter what it is that you are going through concerning your dreams, situations of life and all like that, please don't give up. Don't give up. I just always know that every face, everything that we go through is a face. It doesn't last forever. Once you finish one face, there's another face, there's another face. So the only thing to do is just be ready. And how are you always ready? It's by building yourself up, building yourself spiritually, building yourself economically, building yourself mentally, building yourself in every aspect of life. There's no one way to the approach of life. There's no one way to eat. I don't know who this is for, but this is me genuinely saying that there is no one way to the approaching life. Life is not fair. Life is not fair, but at the end of the day, we have been called to this life for a reason and for a purpose. So you are not here by mistake. There is a reason why you are here. So please don't give up. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your goals. Don't give up on your desires. Don't give up on it. Don't give up on it. You know, I had a child when I was 20, when I was still in school, and a lot happened. The reason for me to let go of this job, the reason, family pressure, and many other things. I don't want to bore you guys about my story, but my point is, all this will pass. No matter what it is that you are going through, just hold on. Hold on to your faith. I don't know. Hold on to Jesus. Hold on. Hold on to Jesus. Because he's the only one that can do it. He's the only one that can give you that peace. The world will always be against you one way or the other. There's no two ways about it. They are there. There are forces there to just negate everything that you try to do. You try to make forge ahead. There's one hindrance, but you have to be resilient. You have to hold on. Know your why. Have your why. Do you understand? Have your why so much that no matter the noises around you, from family, from anyone, you are not hearing. Not that you are not feeling the pain or the hurt, but there's a why. When you hold on to that why, when you hold on to Jesus with that your why, that reason why you have to be, there is a reason. There is a reason you are here. The Bible says you are the light of the world, the salt of the earth. You are not here by mistake. If you were not meant to be here, you would not have been given back to. So for you to be going through that challenge is because there's something inside of you that needs to be battered. So please, guys, don't give up. I don't know who this is for again, but please don't give up. Don't give up on your dreams. It is legit. It is achievable. It is achievable. Don't be patient. Progress, progress, and keep praying.
Bible says, pray without ceasing. Keep praying, keep praying, keep praying, declaring over your life. Read the word of God. Read your Bible. Know what the Bible says concerning you. So when those thoughts come, you will negate it with the word of God. You will negate every word, every counsel of hell with the word of God. You will know that this is what the Lord has said concerning me. And the fact that he does not lie. He does not lie. He does not lie. When he says he will do it, he will do it. He will do it. I am a living testimony of what God can do, how God can change one's life. The things you feel like it is right that you are doing, it is not. It is not. But as you release yourself to him, he begins to work in you and you start seeing your mistakes. Many people may have been saying you are this, you are that, but you are not seeing it. But when you release yourself to the Holy Spirit, it makes you to see where it is. Those things that people are complaining about that is wrong. Because it will be a detriment to your life. So please, don't give up. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up. It is achievable. Everything that you desire is achievable. It is achievable. If you guys would like me to drop a content concerning situations and the things that how I've been able to navigate my life, even after giving birth at the age of 19, 20, and my story, if you would like to hear it, because I know that I'm not the only one. A lot of people go through this. A lot of people are going through things. Everybody has their own. No, everybody has their own. There's nobody that is all perfect. But the approach that you give to it is what matters. The approach is what matters. And God will help us all in Jesus' name. So yeah, you can see that I'm blending, guys. I'm just blending. Like I told you in my previous video, can you see what I'm doing? Once I blend the concealer out, and it tends to go towards the contour or the blush that I've already applied, I use my blush area to cover it again, to blend into each other. That way you don't see where one thing is starting, one blend highlight is starting and contour is starting. So you blend into each other. And before you apply powder to under the eye, make sure that you blend the under eye in order not to have any creasing under the eye. So this is me applying powder to everywhere that I highlighted, and everywhere that I highlighted. So after that, I just kept adding powder to everywhere I highlighted. Then my contour, I also added powder to my contour because it was cream contour that I did. So I have to add powder to increase the intensity of the contour. And that's what I just kept doing and kept doing. Then I applied powder, skin tone powder to every area of the face. Guys, this is where the game changing is. When you do this, you blend out every ash line that may be between the contour, highlights, and every other thing that you have done before. The brow tutorial, I did the brow tutorial. I saw that the brow was very nice and I recorded it really nice. So I'm going to post that separately on my videos. You are going to see that brow separately. I'm going to put it up separately. Guys, I'm really sorry. Yeah, there was no light. So when I was on, the light was taken. They took the light here. And by the time I realized the other light, I was supposed to put it on by myself. So I forgot that I was supposed to put the other light on by myself. So it was only the LED light that was on here. That was why this eyeshadow look was not looking bright. But I feel like you can still see what I'm doing. That's why I still added it to the video. So this is what I just kept doing. Keep blending the colors that I'm using together. I didn't have that shade of blue that was used in the look I'm recreating, but blue is blue. That's why I said recreation is not all about you copying what they did from ear to toe, because you're not there. The ability to recreate and think of other things to do, that is what recreation is all about. So I decided to use this navy blue instead of the sky blue color that was used, because I didn't have that in any of my palettes. I did actually, but I forgot. I had it in one of my old palettes like that, but I did not remember until now. I'm just remembering now that I had the blue. But it is what it is. It still came out fine, Abby. It still came out nice. Tell me now. It still came out nice. So, this is... Please, before you touch our skin, make sure you dust off any eyeshadow that was under the eye. Remember, the work of the setting powder is to be able to hold up any fallout from the eyeshadow in order not for it to stick to the skin. So, if you go and mistakenly start lining our under eye without cleaning off or sweeping off the excess eyeshadow fallout, then that will be a great mistake, because you are going to have pressed the eyeshadow to our skin and it will be very difficult for you to swipe out or sweep out. So yeah, I'm fixing our lashes, and I just find fixing lashes on camera easy. Most people will say they fix it off camera, maybe because of time, but I just feel it's easier to post once you are able to ascertain the lash line, the original lash line. Then you just place your lashes there, and that is it. Then I went over with the lips. I went on to the lips, sorry, and this is it. I went on with a brown shade from my lip palette from Iwe. I think it's Blossom lip palette. Then I mixed some colors from the Blossom lip palette on my mixing pan, and I used it to blend off the brown that I have right now, and this is what I'm just doing. Keep blending. To pop the look, I took two shades from my eyeshadow palette and I used it to create this amazing lip. Look at how beautiful it is. Oof. Yes, you can use eyeshadow, a matte eyeshadow for lip, and it will come out well. It won't crack if you blend well. It will not crack. If you need a video on that, let me know. But a lot of things can be done. Like I said in my previous video, I think two videos before this, that a lot of products can be improvised to create makeup. That is why it is art. Makeup is art. Look at this beauty. Look at the look. Then I went ahead and added gloss to the lip. And if it was going, if you will have thought because it's eyeshadow, it's going to clean off. But no. See it. So application matters a lot. And this is the finished look. The matte look and the glossy look. Let me know which one is your favorite in the comment section. Thank you.